Hello, I'm Joe Walensky. I work at Blink, and we're the producers of the ConveyUX conferences. We've been doing our event in Seattle for 7 years now, and we'll be doing an eighth year in 2020 in Seattle. But what I wanted to talk about today is a special event that we have coming up that's going to be in Boston this summer, August 15 and 16. And the special theme is the nexus of product and UX. And one of the fun things that I always get to do when we're getting ready for conferences is talk to our many speakers. And so today I am fortunate to be talking with Kristian Koelckl. Hello, Kristian. How are you doing today?
Hi, Joe. Just doing fine. Good talking to you.
Well, it's good to have you in the program. I'm speaking from Blink Seattle Waterfront Headquarters office. Where are you talking to us from?
I'm joining you from Boston today, where we'll have the conference in August.
Well, why don't we start with you talking a little bit about your background and the types of things that you're involved in?
Sure, absolutely. Happy to tell you more about that. I'm currently an associate professor at Northeastern University, heading the experience design program there, which we've been running for a bit more than 2 years. My own background, though, is in industrial design. I've trained, had an education in industrial design, worked in industry, in education, in industry, in the field of industrial design in Europe, back in Europe, originally from Austria. And then gradually moved more and more towards the work with digital technologies, screen-based and ambient-based digital technologies, a work that then brought me to Boston, working over the arc of 7 years with a research lab at MIT on the focus of digital cities, the nexus of responsive digital network technologies and urban environments, headed a research group within that lab for a number of years, as part of which we set up a team in Singapore for research purposes. And then joined Northeastern University, where we've had a lot of exciting things happening in the space of design, particularly in the space of experience design, a field that We've worked on at the undergraduate level for several years already, and where we've developed the master's program over the last few years, and that's now been running for 2 to 3 years.
Well, your introduction brings me also to mention that we're very pleased to be working on ConveyUX Boston in cooperation with Northeastern University, and that's how you and I first met, and now you're a part of the program. The topic that you're going to be speaking to us at the conference is something that's very tied in with all the work that you're doing at Northeastern. The title is Thingprovisation, Creating Value Through Design Beyond Scripts and Plans. So tell us a little bit about your talk and how that relates to the research work that you do.
Sure, absolutely. It relates a lot to my research, but also to my experience as a practitioner, I'd say. You know, as designers, we always like plans. We like programs, scripts. And ultimately, we like to control things. Problem with that is that I've increasingly come to realize that life does not follow plans, and people don't follow plans. And increasingly, the technologies we work with in the realm of experience design, interaction design, these technologies have become increasingly context and situation aware. They're able to pick up on what is actually happening. What are people actually doing? Not what we thought they would be doing, or what we'd like to have them do, or script them to do, or program to do, but you know what is actually happening, because it's quite unpredictable, unforeseeable, if you're honest. And so technologies that are responsive in real time can pick up on what's happening and reconfigure, adjust, and adapt their own behavior towards the activity of people, the context, the environmental context, their own system state or histories of that system state to adjust and adapt and really engage in a situation. Increasingly, when reflecting on that, I've done a lot of work in the realm of what I like to refer to as hybrid city rather than the more common smart city term. Much of that work has drifted towards controlled, top-down, and surveillance-based operations. But what I've realized is that this situation-specific and context-specific back and forth between people and their environment, their technology-imbued environment, is increasingly becoming similar to an improvisation, a back and forth where the action of each part influences what the other part is going to do. And both people adjust and adapt to their built environment or to their responsive interactive service that they're encountering. But also these services, these embedded technologies can adjust and adapt. And so improvisation just seemed a much better analogy and a metaphor and a model to look at these interactions that some of the past models of interactions that we've been using. And so building on those past models, I've looked intensely at improvisation. Not improvisation in terms of developing new use cases or user scenarios, which is something that in the design field we've done for many years and it's worked very well, but really improvisation in terms of how does improvised interaction happen between people, between performers and actors, and learn from that to inform how we structure our products, our objects, our environments, how we imbue some of these abilities to improvise into our products. And looking at improvisation deeply and working with some of improvisational actors on this, it's interesting to look at the term itself. Improvisation comes from proviso, the Latin proviso, which means provision and agreement, something that has been agreed before. And so improvisation means an action that has not been agreed before. Encountering, engaging with an action that has not been agreed before, that comes unexpected and unforeseen. And so the ability to improvise in that way is very much an ability to gracefully deal with something that has not been expected. And I think, imbuing that into the products, the systems that we develop, this graceful ability of dealing with something that could not be expected, is something for which there's a big opening right now. And so that's what I've been working on. That's what my talk would be about as well.
Well, I think that whole idea of being able to build some type of improvisation recognition into the work that we do, it is definitely seems challenging, but certainly seems like an interesting opportunity. And it'll be great to have your insights as both academic and practitioner at the event. So thanks a lot for taking a few short minutes here to talk with me a little bit about your background and your work, and we'll look forward to seeing you in Boston for the conference.
Absolutely. Excited to be there in my hometown here now in August.
All right. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye, Kristian.
Bye, Joe.